Bună ziua! My name is Rafael Mărculescu. I'm representing today KNX Romania Association. What is KNX? Maybe everybody will ask. There is a standard for building automation. It's a building automation standard. Let me start the counter to try to fill in the allocated time. Today I will try to just briefly present what means automation for buildings, and especially lighting automation, why, and few examples, and also to open a future discussion how technically we can obtain and how much we can obtain using the automation, lighting automation in buildings. First thing first, Timișoara, there is a very important city because here a lot of efforts and your efforts today, thank you very much, it's allocated in a way to develop our buildings, to build smarter and smarter and to have something new and nice. We have here the winner of the Green Building of the Year 2009, the City Business Center. Just brief, it's a building management system, it's built inside and take care about lighting automation, about shading systems, heatings, all together. And what is very important in this building automation or building management system, that the systems are working synchronized. So I will not lower the blinds and then switch on the lights, or starting the cooling system and the heating system on the same time. So this is very important. Modern building with a lot of modern solutions inside. Why building automation? Today a lot of energy consumption are made in the cities, and 40% of this is inside the building. So we have to be care to be care about this subject especially. And what means automation? Maybe some of you already know. An automation is referring it's a Latin term, and it's referring to a process that it's happen without human intervention. It's very important, for example, when it's a common area, the lights after a while to switch off automatically, because nobody, just a visitor in the city hall, let's say, will go to switch off the lights in the main hall of the building. Most frequent automation are based on few important things like time programs, like movement detection or present detection. I will go into details a little bit later. Different weather condition, and we have to refer to the rain, to close some windows when it's the case, to retract some exterior shading systems when it's very windy, or to lower the shading system when it's very sunny outside, very hot during summer, and so on. Also, time schedule, also to measure the level of light in the building and to add some extra lighting, electrical artificial lighting if necessary. Of course, we can discuss more and more, but these are the most important. And remember all the time when you need to automate something that you have to base on few of these. It was a very interesting discussion yesterday. Some of you seen the presentations today. Very interesting with lighting, lighting games. Art of light with different color, and the luminaires actually are built in the matrix and act like a huge display, like the polar Nordic lights from yesterday evening projects or the projects presented before. But to keep it simple, talking about automation in buildings, we have first very simple automation, movement detector. There are people in the room that seen or use a movement detector? I'm the only one? Ah, okay. Thank you very much. There are few. Movement detectors like on the corridors, like maybe in public toilets, and so on. Another very simple example, it's the timer used on our flat of buildings. When we go into the staircase, we press a button, then start a timer, automat de casa scărilor. And the lights will switch off after a specific pre-programmed time. There are also centralized logic. What means centralized logic? Talking about yesterday projects, in order to switch on and dim the light of and to change the color of these luminaires in the yesterday project, you need a software, a computer or a controller that will control all of this. But these are more or less local application, not very with very wide coverage, not very, very complex in order to support an entire building. In order to support an entire building, have been designed and built smart devices like presence detector, movement, timers, and also actuators. We're talking about actuators. Imagine a relay that switch on and off the luminaire circuit or the dimmers, variatoare de iluminat in Romania, the lighting dimmers and the RGB controllers that allow us to change the color of the light. This apparatus have to be to communicate each other. And in this way, combining different functions, for example, a timer and the measurement of light, we'll see immediately, make combinations that are really necessary and in the buildings. There are different systems based on this bus-based system with communication between apparatus. Maybe you heard about Modbus, Profibus, LON, BACnet, and so on. Today, one of the most used application, it's the KNX standard. It's just a name, a KNX standard. According to the statistics, this KNX solution is present in today in Europe in most of 75% of the project. Not necessarily the full project, it's only on one bus application. Can be sometimes a combination. For example, on Modbus, there are taking the information from the metering system, from LON, from the chiller, cooling systems, and so on. And all together are integrated in this system that it's popularly named Building Management System, or BMS. Why are we today making automation? There are actually few arguments. And please keep in mind these four, and keep in mind when will be a discussion to implement an automation in the building, and we will ask, but why to do it? And then you'll realize that are some needs behind. One need can be the energy efficiency. That means to be more ecological, to save the planet, to protect the planet from global heating and so on. And also economy, savings, that means also impacting in the budget of the building. Talking about the period when the building is used. Another one can be comfort. Comfort is easy to imagine, and I'll come with examples. I'm entering into a corridor and the lights are automatically switch on. Okay, I'm safe. It's okay. I'm comfortable to go through. And also, I'm safe because I will not make an accident because I cannot see anything. Talking about this, we can go to the next step. That means talking about safety. Safety of humans and safety of equipments of the buildings, for example, monitoring systems that allow us to know if a central heating system is working, a cooling system is working, and so on. Flexibility. This modern solution based on different apparatus that are communicating each other allow us to combine different functions, to combine different functions, and then also to alterate the different parameters. For example, I schedule initially the lights to facade lights to switch on at 7 o'clock. Then I can change it to 6:30 or 7:30. That allow us to make a combination. And I will show you later on also another interesting examples about flexibility. When we are talking about lighting automation, actually, we have to keep in mind two parts of the lighting automation. First, it's related to the natural lights, and second is related to the artificial electrical lighting. I will go through this. Also important in monitoring and metering, but I will not discuss about this today. Relighting motorized system, as these are names, the blind systems, there are different types, can be installed in the building or outside the building. Talking about the efficiency in protecting of the sun radiation and especially infrared, so heating during summer, it's very important to be outside, but it's more complicated. We're talking about just roller shutters, about shutters with slats, like Venetian blinds, jaluzele venețiene, în care putem regla unghiul lamelelor. We are talking about roof windows, also with can be open and close motorized, covers, screens, gate, garage doors, and so on. Let's see some examples. Simple examples that and very useful in houses and also in big buildings like office buildings. There are local control, but also the automation allow to have centralized control. For example, when I leaving the house, press a button, all the rollers are down. And also, this can be integrated in different scenarios. The specific scenarios, I don't know, an alarm, all the blinds are raised up, for example, according to the scenario, in a complex scenarios. Yeah? Or for example, in a meeting room, when I'm pressing a PowerPoint presentation button, the lights are dim, the heating cooling systems is switch on, and also the projector and it switch on, and the screen it's lowered in proper position. As long as I'm putting the blinds together, I can implement astro functions. That means to know when the sunlight it's very strong, to lower the systems, and this should be done, should be treated for each facade, because we can have east, south, and west, and they will not lower and raised together, for sure. I mentioned before about the weather condition based automation. I mentioned about the lowering of the shutter system in order to protect against very strong sun during during summer. Also, if the wind is too strong and I have outside shading systems, this should be, should be retracted. These shutter systems are also very useful in office buildings, in schools, and so on, because allow to have proper light, and also allow us to shadow the rooms when the sun is very strong, in order to assure very nice climate during during summer, and vice versa during winter, to raise up and to add some extra heating from the sun. In schools, very important. Also, when the sun is very low during winter, during cold season, it's important to have blinds with slats that allow us to have some light in the room, but not direct ray of lights that are not so pleasant. Also, automation sometimes help us when you cannot get up from the bed. It's very pleasant to have it. And sometimes when you wake up in the morning, to have a button next to your bed, wake up, the blinds are first raised only 5 centimeters, after a while another 10, and so on and so forth. And if possible also to switch on the coffee machine. I think it's something that will make us the lights more comfortable, more pleasant. Talking about artificial electric lighting control. Talking about movement detectors. The movement detector is a detector that detects the infrared of the body, and infrared when it's moved, not when it's stationary, like a heating system, calorifer. Most of the time there are two sensors inside. One sensor detects the movement, and one the level of light. The level of light. If it's enough light, we'll not switch on the lighting system. It's very practical, and normally are used on that area that normally the people are not staying and have activities, but just pass through. Reception areas, stairs, dressing, we are spending, I don't know, 5-10 minutes, and then we leave. Presence detectors. Presence detectors should be a movement detector more accurate, that in a better way feel that the people are in the room. And normally have two functions. One function is like in the movement detectors, to switch on the light, depending of the lighting level in the room, of course. But another transparent function is to switch on the heating cooling system. This is something it's good to know. So the lighting and heating are starting automatically, but we still have to go to take our cup of coffee. Now let's make some interesting applications. For example, we are installing a twilight sensor for the facade or yard lighting. When the sun lighting are going down here at threshold, the lighting system is switched on. And in the morning, when the sun is strong again, the lighting system is switched off. But somebody will come and said, why to stay all the night long? No, I want also to implement a time schedule device that, that at 11 o'clock in the night we'll switch off the light and we'll switch on again in the morning. And the third person will say, oh, but it's not good enough, because if I'll go outside during the night, I need light. And then will be installed a third detector, a third sensor, a movement detector, this sphere include inside the movement detector, that will switch on the light for a few minutes only when the movement detection, the movement is detected. And maybe it's only one apparatus, or maybe are two or three linked together. This is something that can be easy done using a smart system, a system at 2016, 2017, very close here. Time schedules also are used on common areas, as I mentioned. But interesting, two things I would like to underline. First, we can define in between different time hours to have a lower, brighter level or a darker level of light, for example, during night. And this will bring us as well, so do not switch completely off. And also talking about very modern solution, sometimes the people said, I will put two circuits, lamp, first lamp, the third one, fifth one, and so on, and I will keep it, switch it on at 50% lighting. I will keep it only these lamps switch on during night. But what is the disadvantage? The disadvantage that I will not have the same uniformity of light. And sometimes it's unpleasant. And today, apparatus, today devices allow us to reduce, to dim the level of lighting. Groups and scenes. Modern solution allow us to group the lamps. Please have a look here. Here it's a combination of KNX system with DALI luminaires via KNX DALI gateway. And this DALI allow us to switch on and, let's say, control each lamp individually, but also to group them. Then we can have scenes, then we can have sequences, like in theater, sequence one, sequence two, and so on, with different group of lamps and different lighting intensity. I will mention here, very interesting for a person that come in front of you and have some emotion, how the presentation will be, to have a button to press PowerPoint presentation. That's the button. The screen is in right position, the projector is working, the lights are quite good, dimmed. So the first step. So this is comfort, this is automation, but also comfort. It's also energy savings if we are dimmed down the lights, and so on and so forth. So remember the four arguments I mentioned before: energy efficiency, comfort, safety, security of installation of person, and flexibility. A very interesting function I would like also to mention, it's the constant lighting. What means? Let's imagine we have an office building and there is natural light, but during night the intensity of natural lighting it's going down. Automatically the electrical, the artificial lighting it's increased in order to compensate. And the sum, it's create a constant lighting for the place, on the place, on the table, we have to, working place. interesting that if we have shading systems, these shading systems should be also connected to the system, and to have only one system, as I mentioned before, not to lower down the shading system when it's sun. When the sun is moved, let's say, to the south, but the shading system is down and the lights are switched on. It's very important to link together all the functions of the building. And this should be done actually only with a modern solution. Just to have a look here, when the sun lighting is going down, with electrical lighting we can compensate. What is happened here? Sometimes we can make also, due to the flexibility of the system, to combine the movement or present detection with the this constant lighting. If the person are not in the room, the lights will switch off, of course. Case studies, few examples, practical examples. University of Bremen, Germany. In order to underline the power of the automation, they took two similar classrooms. It's 123 and 122, and the second one have been implemented modern solution like constant lightings with two rows of luminaires, one next to the window, one next to the wall, to the corridor, with control of heating and so on, and ventilation and so on and so forth. Do not forget that the second the standard installation also have been built with manual control, with thermostats, with on the radiators. So it's not, how to say, without any automation, but with a standard, let's say, automation, with the central heating automation, and so on. It's very important that they took two rooms with the same condition, because we can make really make a comparison, a right one, because the rooms are in the same condition. Not I make a measurements this year with 20 degrees, and next year when it's very rainy and cloudy and there are 4 degrees. And said, no, this year I spend more energy. I spend more energy, but the conditions were different. Okay, regarding heating systems, the measurements have been done, as you can see, during 5 years. This is the heating energy spent in the normal classroom, and this is with good automation. Talking about lighting, what is important for us today, due to the, despite the fact that in Germany there are quite educated people and take care about this, and they constantly switch off the light when it is not necessary, we can see that in a normal October day, not in the summer, not in the winter, in a normal October day, the consumption is, let's say, half using a smart controlling system with this function constant light. Global results of the study, that we can have savings like 50% for heating, 45% due to the control of the shutter system, lighting control, ventilation, and so on and so forth. These data are present on the KNX page. It's the KNX Association in Brussels. I'll come later on page. Okay, going out from the building and talking about a city, an entire city, it's about Salzburg, a really huge city, have been asked for a control system for the entire, to switch on and off, to control the entire lighting system of the city. The requirements were a lot, to don't switch on and off the lighting system too often, because the type of luminaires does not allow this, and also will reduce the lamp lifetime, and so on. Interesting that during evening, the system will be switched off at 140 lux, and in the morning, because the eye and the body, the human, are adapt to the low level of lighting, the value it's much lower. Normally, a just simple twilight sensor bought from the shop here will be 140, and in the morning will be like 200 because of this hysteresis that usually are implemented in the devices in order to don't switch on and off the lighting too often. Okay, having built a, if you'll see here, all the apparatus are duplicate, a redundant system that are taking care about this. Also here are two twilight sensors, and interesting that also the system 4 minutes before to switch on the lighting will send a message to the energy producer to inform that, I don't know, 4 megawatts, I don't know, will be switched on in few minutes to prepare the power system. Another example is, and maybe the most famous one, it's to implement a lighting system in the aeronautic industry, as was mentioned. Terminal 5 from Heathrow, it's actually a city. If I'm correct, there are few thousand employees. Few thousand employees. And you can imagine how many tourists are going through the corridors during only one day. It's a really huge installation that from KNX point of view, that means to build few systems linked together, but it was a nice challenge and nice implementation. So we can adapt from a very, very small system to a huge city level, the lighting automation. Also interesting and challenging project, it was the flatfish farming de calcani, o fabrică de calcani at Corbu, at Black Sea Side, have been request to be implemented the circadian rhythm lighting, and keep in mind that the lamps are going from 0 to 100% in 3 hours. Keep in mind that in summer the day is longer and in winter is shorter. So all of these have been implemented in with few, how to say, off the shelves apparatus, smart apparatus, have been implemented in this functionality, and the factory, the farming, the farm it's working successfully, I think, for at least 5 years. Please. Aha, the light color, no, and this is the light temperature, yeah? No, it's not implemented. It was request, and I was also, involved in this as consultant. It was request only the light level, but not. In another project, it's about a surveillance system where the people are working in shifts, very long shifts, like 24 hours, have been implemented a solution that was mentioned yesterday with LED lighting, cold and warm. The warm one or the cold one, it's enough for a good and uniform lighting, but with this combination have been sure two. One, to increase and decrease the light intensity from, from the normal one, minimum one, to quite double one, and also to change the color temperature. It's very interesting. It was a very long discussion with support from Cluj, from Mr. Dorin Beu, maybe you know the person. We find some solution and have been implemented in this KNX solution. Here, as I mentioned, only the intensity of the lighting, and keep in mind also the period of year. But the fish are happy. Who recognized this room? It's the room we are standing now. Here also have been asked for quite challenging time to dim down and up the lights in 6 minutes. So to go very, very, very slow. It's an implementation of KNX with DALI system on luminaires. Interesting project. I will finish with this. Just before finish, two slides, please allow me to mention again about KNX. There is a standard. The standard have been designed and make all the preparation to become from a solution, a standard, by an association in Brussels. It's an association of manufacturers. There are more than 400 manufacturers, all the most common electrical manufacturers, heating, cooling system manufacturers, and so on. It's a long list where you'll recognize a lot of big names. Have like 26 years of experience. And very interesting, despite the widespread, as you can see, very interesting that everybody can use the technology without being forced to pay any money for trade of or patents. Everybody can use the technology. It's free of charge, let's say. Very interesting, and maybe due to this have such a big penetration in the projects. In Romania, few peoples, very enthusiastic, also build a local association, named it KNX Romania. I'm representing today this association, this organization. And the aim is to promote the automation technology, the KNX-based automation technology, the green buildings, and also support the engineers, the technicians, the electricians, the professionals that need support in this direction through trainings, different technical presentations, documentation, online support, and so on. If you need any support, just remember KNX Romania. It's very easy here, knx.ro, or if you want to be inform, follow this or Asociația KNX Romania on Facebook to be informed about events, about trainings, and so on. As long as you need support, as long as you feel that a presentation, a training will be good, and especially here in Timișoara, we have also members of the association that are based here and they can support us based on your request, of course, to organize these events. Now is the time for your questions, please. I will invite you later on. There are some person that already told me that we'll talk in during the next break. Let me say very warm thank you for being here, for organizer, for you all that spend your time and efforts to build smarter and smarter in Romania. Thank you very much.